class 6, welcome back to bio class. I hope you must have watched the last video where we have started chapter number 1, chapter number 2, the flowers, right? And if you remember, we have discussed about what is flower, at the same time what are the parts of flower, right? And for your recap, let's just take a short recap what we have done. In the last class, we have learned that the flower is made up of, you know, it is arranged in whorls, and it has got four whorls. The outermost whorl is called calyx, where you get to see the sepals, the pedicel and thalamus. They are the part of this first whorl, the outermost whorl. Then the second whorl, we come to the petals. All the petals, as many petals are there, they make the next whorl or the next layer of the flower. After that, like, you know, we have discussed about the third layer or third whorl of the flower, that is androecium, which is male reproductive part and which consists of two parts, that is filament and anther, right? Then we have discussed about the fourth whorl, that is the male reproductive part, which is made up of three main parts, that is called the topmost is stigma, then the pipe-like structure or tube-like structure is known as style, and then it has got the swollen part, which is known as ovary, and inside the ovary the seeds, the ovules are present, and the future of flower is fruit, and from the fruit again the ovules, which are present in the ovary, they form the seeds. Now I'll show you here, these things we have done yesterday, the parts of flower. Then we have discussed about all the whorls, four whorls, and we have also discussed about their function, right? Now today in this video we are going to discuss about the next topic, that is the types of flower. There are basically different types of flower, right? Now we are going to learn about the first type of flower, that is complete and incomplete flower. As you know that we have discussed about the parts of flower, the outermost layer, calyx, then corolla, after that androecium, then gynoecium. Okay, so complete flower means what? Complete flower means a flower which has all the four whorls, then only it is called a complete flower. For example, like in China rose, mustard seeds, then peas, these are mustard flower also has got all the whorls. Then pea flower also has got all the whorls, like all the four whorls it has. Then we come to the next, the contradictory part, that is incomplete flower. What is an incomplete flower? An incomplete flower, of course, you can understand from here, some part or like one or the other whorl is missing. Basically, the male or female, male is called androecium, right? And female part is called, reproductive part is called the gynoecium. Either of these two, if they are missing, then that flower is known as incomplete flower. For example, date palm, mulberry, these are the example of incomplete flower, right? Now, after this, we have another type of flower, that is unisexual and bisexual. Now, what is the meaning of unisexual and bisexual? With the word, you know what is the meaning of uni? Uni means one, bi means two. Now what is unisexual? Unisexual and bisexual. What is the meaning of unisexual? Unisexual means a flower which will have only one reproductive part. Either it will have male reproductive part or it will have female reproductive part. That type of flower will be known as unisexual flower, okay? That means it will have only one reproductive part. And bisexual means, bi means two. That means those flowers which have both bi, both male and female reproductive part, they are known as bisexual flower. Like for example, in your book, you will get to see picture of bisexual flower is given here, that is hibiscus. This is a very common example of bisexual flower. That is, we also know, like call it as China rose. Okay, in Bengali, I think it is known as Joba Kusum. Right. So you will see here, this particular flower has got all the four, both the male and female part. It has got stamen. Also, it has pistil. That means anther the ovary and gynecium, all the parts are there. Both male and female reproductive parts are present in China rose. But there, that is why it is known as bisexual flower. Okay. So I hope you have understood what is the difference between unisexual flower and bisexual flower. It means bisexual flower is the flower which will have both male and female reproductive parts. That means both the reproductive parts it will have. And unisexual flower means it will have only one reproductive part. Either it will have male reproductive part or it will have female reproductive part. And the example for unisexual flower is, you will see in page number 25, the examples are papaya, watermelon, cucumber, bitter gourd, pumpkin, etc. Okay, and bisexual flower example is China rose, mustard, pea, lily, and gulmohar also. So they are bisexual flower. Now we will discuss about the function of flower. So far we have learned what is flower. Okay, then we have learned about the parts of flower. Then we have learned the types of flower, right? Now what is the function of flower? What do you think? What can be the function of flower? Now you see, in the parts of flower we have read about the reproductive, flower is a reproductive, flower is basically the reproductive part of the plant. Means what? It helps in the reproduction. How does it help in the reproduction? It has got male and female reproductive part which will fuse together and can, which will fuse together and will in future will form the fruit, and then fruit will bear the seeds, and then seeds will further grow into a new plant. That's how it is. That is why it is called the flower is the reproductive part of the plant, right? So the function of flower is what? It helps in reproduction, first function. The second function is what? It helps to bear fruits and flower, and from the flower then fruit will bear, come, and from the fruit then seeds will be there. Now when does this will happen? This fruits, when will it come out, and when does this seed will come out? Okay, when this process are taking place? This will happen only when very two important processes are occurring in the plant. That is, first one is called pollination and second is fertilization. Okay, now what we will do? This pollination and fertilization we are going to discuss in the next class. And till then, what you are going to do? Your work is to write the difference between the two types of flower what we have studied. Okay, that is complete and incomplete flower. At the same time, unisexual and bisexual flower. Write at least 2 points for each types of flower. Fine. And at the same time, in the last class, you have, as I have told you, you have to draw all these diagrams. And I hope you must have drawn this diagram, right? And do read the topic also. Okay. So you will find exercise for revision. Page number 27. Look here, page number 27. You have certain exercises to do. We will discuss that. The reproductive part of the plant is, you see the options are given, and the correct option is flower. Then question number 2. Pollen grains are produced in which part of the flower? It is produced in the anther. Okay, not in the filament. Reproductive whorls of a flower are androecium and gynoecium. Only these two. They are the reproductive whorls. Which of the following is not a unisexual flower? Means unisexual, remember, that is having only one sex organ. That is, either it will have male or female reproductive part. Papaya, cucumber, mustard seeds and pumpkin. So which one is not a unisexual flower? flower? The answer is mustard, because mustard is having both male and female part. Number 5, what is the main function of flower? Just now we have discussed, the main function of flower is to produce fruits and seeds. Okay, that's it. Now question number B, circle the odd one and name the category to which other three belongs. China rose, mustard, pea, date palm. Now date palm is the odd one out, and the rest of them are coming under, we can say they are complete flowers. Okay. And date palm is an incomplete flower. Now question number 2, rose, lily, gulmohar, cucumber. Now just find out the answer by yourself, everything I have told you. Okay. So you will do this in your book itself and send me your work for correction. Till then, keep studying and take care. Bye-bye.